So, hi everyone, I'm Claudio Stanke, Senior Research Analyst at IDC. I'm here with Johan Fortini from Konica Minolta, who's going to talk to us about how the modern workplace is interconnected to cybersecurity and what is Konica Minolta's vision. But why don't you introduce yourself, Johan?
Thanks a lot, Claudio, and indeed I will. So nice to meet you everyone as well. So I'm Johan Fortini from Konica Minolta. I'm actually in charge of IT's go-to-market strategy into our digital workplace division, and I will be happy to share with all of you and with Claudio about our cybersecurity vision.
Perfect. Thank you, Johan. So tell us, what is Konica Minolta's vision about integrating cybersecurity in your client's company culture?
Okay, so about this one, I would say that for most of our customer, security is a part of the overall digital transformation story. Many of our customers are facing the digital transformation challenge internally and externally. And first of all, we believe that digital transformation is a cultural challenge, a cultural thing. And for this reason, we think that security should be treated the same way. Means we should inoculate in the company some security culture and turn it not into a constraint or a processing constraint, but really a business enabler, maybe even an opportunity. Then secondly, the biggest needs of our customer today is actually to provide a seamless, consolidated, and comprehensive digital ecosystem. They want the things to run smoothly and, more importantly, together. Cybersecurity is a part of that journey. And at Konica Minolta, we are not only providing security solutions and services by themselves, but we are also, as we like to say, connected the dot. We are connecting them and making them work together. One of our best examples is probably Workplace App Platform, which is an all-in-one consolidated digital workplace enabler so the customer can focus on their business. And the last principle, most of our business owners are looking for empathy, proximity, understanding, productivity, improvement, all this kind of thing. They don't want cybersecurity to be black art or rocket science, but they want the security offer to fit their needs. And so we can, again, support their business activity and allow them to keep focus on their daily productivity.
Great, thanks. So how do you actually see this being different in small and medium businesses that have never worried about before about security?
So I think the first answer is probably in your question. The awareness, the consideration change a lot. By the past, it can sound like an easy saying thing, but most of our customers were simply not aware about how security is important for their business, how it's a critical point. And even if sometimes among security experts and so on, we are suffering a bit of a groupthink syndrome, I think we have to realize and to recognize that the market maturity in this field is still pretty low. Mm-hmm. The second point for our customer, still, as we said, as I said earlier, most of our customers are actually small and medium business customers, which means they are not aiming to become security experts. Again, they want to run their business, and they are expecting us to secure it. And obviously, there is an elephant in the room, right? COVID-19. The COVID-19 pandemic increased the awareness and the criticality of security needs a lot also in SMB, where it was maybe by the past a kind of subtopic. And especially in such area like data protection, remote working, or business continuity. So we see here the big change.
Yeah, well, great, thanks. So, and regarding best practices, what do you see them to be like when integrating new solutions in an environment?
So we have a couple of best practices which are, I have to say, basically true for every new digital services or digital solution. So the first one, as I said earlier, consider holistic approach, holistic picture, with end user first. So customers are buying, but end user is utilizing, adopting, and changing, and promoting. And this is also true for security. CISO is deciding and buying, but the end user is adopting. The second recommendation will be to keep it simple. Again, to avoid sophisticated picture or hard to understand language, but really to keep it simple so everyone can feel involved and adopt it. The last best practice, or almost the last actually, the third best practice is maybe the most important and underestimated one in my eyes is to shift from company institution, from company institutional and organizational culture to collaboration and cross-functional culture and organization. Means the topic first and the setup later. The company and the daily business like stability and big setup and so on, but when you are introducing new solution and new services, this requires disruption and checking the daily status quo. So which means more agile leadership, flexible team, topic-based discussion. Maybe even different setup or separate dedicated team sometimes makes sense depending on the topic. And to catch up with your two previous questions, security is actually for us in the same situation, still a new topic. The security culture, solution and services are the one. And we recommend all this practice also in the security area and also to integrate security at the first place for every new solution and services. Because integrating security from the start is always more efficient and less expensive at the end than considering the topic later.
Absolutely. So, and what are the main challenges in bridging the gap between the real workplace and the digital one?
So again, pretty exhaustive and nice question. We know very well in Konica Minolta because we are also historically printing manufacturer, as you know, and now moving to the digital world. So something we are facing internally and externally. But the main challenge, I would say, first of all, the resistance, the fear, the lack of knowledge. So again, among experts, among knowledge worker or ITS thinker, we may believe that everyone is pretty aware about all this topic, especially the digital one. But the reality is that majority of the workers, especially in SMB world, but not only, are still on their learning curve, right? Even with digital native are really now coming on the market. Most of the people are still wondering how they can use the best this digital ecosystem for them, for their business, and so on. So I think to solve the first challenge, vulgarization and adoption are needed. And this is why in Konica Minolta, one of our motto is keep it simple, also for security. Second recurring challenge is some wordings and concept mix up. And we see a lot of users, a lot of customers actually mixing up digitization and digital transformation, which is the real move into the digital ecosystem. Digitization for us is the basic conversion of analog and physical existing process to digital. While digital transformation is going far beyond, and it can be it can end with totally rethinking the business model and operation. So we understand that digitization is often a first step into the overall digital jump. But if we are mixing up and only staying at the first step, this can create some lack of value or disappointment. Another challenge we see is also a lot of projects still starting at first with technological and product-based discussion instead of business and functional analysis. So we discussed earlier that the entry point should be the user needs. And when shifting from physical to digital area, again, one of our biggest challenge and our best advice probably will be start to rethink about your business, the business model, your strategy, your positioning, the processes first, and the setup, the technology, the product second. And the last one, because our discussion is around mostly about security context, again, still today, so maybe after COVID-19 might be a bit different, but still security topic look like a neglected topic or side topic or complementary topic. And we definitely recommend to integrate them from the start. Otherwise, we can have big showstopper later on. For example, functional showstopper, but also legal them like GDPR, for example. So that's about our challenge and recommendation.
Well, great, thanks. So last question. So do you have any interesting real life examples on how Konica Minolta has solved cybersecurity related issues for their clients?
Yeah, so interesting a lot, right? As you can imagine. If I try to limit the list with the three, four which are coming to my mind now, maybe two first one illustrating the comprehensive approach and the integrated ecosystem I just mentioned earlier. One from France, customer, healthcare customers called ADP Laboratory, which unfortunately suffered from a cryptovirus attack. And after this attack, they decided to improve, of course, their security level, but not only. They worked with us and they adopted the Konica Real Data Workplace app. And actually, through this security attack and this security strategy, they even rebuilt their whole IT and digital ecosystem a more integrated way, and so they can focus on the business and everything about IT digital is centralized somewhere and they don't have to take care about it. They are trusting us to take care of this backbone and infrastructure.
Yeah.
Second example in the same ID is DB Schenker from Germany, which is a branch from the famous Deutsche Bahn. And this branch is providing supply chain management and logistics solution. So one of the challenges of DB Schenker was to mix physical and digital security. And to do this, we've been working together in integrating some video monitoring solution based on Konica Minolta Mobotics camera. Mm-hmm. And this system is mixing both physical security through the video monitoring, but also digital security with, for example, integrating prevention of network penetration into the cameras, intelligent capture and move analysis, easy maintenance, and all this kind of thing. That's for the two horizontal workplace example. But one of the things I would like also to mention is that Konica Minolta can also adapt and address the needs when, for example, the request is mostly about higher level of security. Mm-hmm. And two other examples which are also coming to my mind are coming from North America. And unfortunately, two customers I cannot mention because, you know, not everyone is willing to promote that they got some security failure or mm-hmm. pen test ongoing, right? So the first customer is one customer from the USA, and this customer was facing a big challenge defining critical security control maturity evaluation and policy in 19 days to prepare the 2021 investment plan. Mm-hmm. So to address this as soon as possible, we assigned and we actually fully dedicated to him for 19 days one of our senior cybersecurity experts, one of the security consultants. And hand in hand with the customer, they went through such gap assessment and the security policy and so on in less than 3 months, which was a big achievement by itself. Maybe more importantly, this was a good opportunity for the customers to rethink his whole security policy, especially on three angles, protecting data, proper incident report, which is also another critical point, and at the end, addressing security again a holistic way through the whole digital ecosystem. And the last example, pretty linked to this one, and which will be probably connected with our first question, is another example for North America. All I can say is that we are talking here about a third-party banking platform from an international financial institution. Interesting point for this customer is that they ask us to do some pen testing on this web platform. And actually, we found out some vulnerability. We notified them to the customers who we initially didn't want to believe. So we have to perform some fake attack with their internal team. And then everyone was aware about this security vulnerabilities and so on. And this totally changed the picture from the whole company about security culture. Well, so I like these 3-4 examples.
Yeah. Well, and thanks for that, Johan. I can see that now we're out of time. So thank you very much again for all this. And we will all see you soon.
Sure. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Johan.